Prince Harry and his grandmother Queen Elizabeth II are known for having a close relationship, but following the Duke of Sussex's marriage to Meghan Markle last year, the monarch rejected a heartwarming wish made by her grandson. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle married in May last year and welcomed son Archie Harrison into the world just under a year later. The couple has since settled into family life at Frogmore Cottage, where they spent millions of taxpayers' money renovating the royal residence. However, Harry had reportedly hoped for a different estate as their home, something the Queen firmly rejected. According to the Sunday Times, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex initially wanted to live at Windsor Castle with Queen Elizabeth II and Prince Philip. The report, written by Rosa Nicar, reads, "The couple are understood to have set their hearts at first on Windsor Castle, and are believed to have asked the Queen if living quarters could be made available after their marriage." However, the newlyweds' request was turned down by the Queen, who instead gifted them the Windsor-based Frogmore Cottage. Royal author Hugo Vickers explained why the Queen might have done this. He said, "There are empty bedrooms and suites in the private apartments within Windsor Castle which the Sussexes may have had their eye on, or perhaps some former living quarters in the castle grounds converted into other things. But I can see how it might not be entirely appropriate to have a young family living there." But although Meghan and Harry were not able to live at the castle, the town of Windsor has proven to be a place of deep significance to them. A statement released by Kensington Palace ahead of the Sussexes' 2018 wedding read, "As with all members of the royal family, Windsor is a very special place for Prince Harry, and he and Ms. Markle have regularly spent time there over the last year and a half. Prince Harry and Ms. Markle are delighted that the beautiful grounds of Windsor Castle will be where they begin their lives together as a married couple." Frogmore Cottage, which is on the grounds of Windsor Castle, has since been turned into the Duke and Duchess of Sussex's dream home. Earlier this year, royal accounts showed the Duke and Duchess of Sussex spent £2.4 million of taxpayers' money renovating the place. Although Meghan and Harry paid for some of the fittings themselves, the cost of replacing ceiling beams, floor joists, heating, gas, electrical systems, and replumbing was met by the public purse. Royal aide Sir Michael Stevens, keeper of the Privy Purse, said, "The property had not been the subject of work for some years and had already been earmarked for renovation in line with our responsibility to maintain the condition of the occupied Royal Palace's estate. The building was returned to a single residence and outdated infrastructure was replaced to guarantee the long-term future of the property." He added Harry and Meghan had paid for substantially all fixtures and fittings. After the couple's wedding last year, Meghan and Harry lived in the two-bedroom Nottingham cottage, in the grounds of Kensington Palace. The couple moved to Windsor ahead of the birth of Archie, who was born on May 6. Summer is in full swing now, and it's the time of year when all the royals pay a visit to the Queen at her Scottish retreat, Balmoral Castle. But planning hasn't been easy for palace staff amid tense royal relations. Balmoral Castle, acquired by Queen Victoria in 1852, is one of the Queen's favorite places. She spends at least 2 months there every summer, and close members of family are all expected to visit at some point. But with Prince William and Prince Harry's visits clashing this year, staff have had to reshuffle the sleeping arrangements. Courtiers at the Queen's Balmoral estate plan every detail of the royal summer meticulously. Not only will the royals visit, but the Prime Minister, often bringing their partner, so in this case, Boris Johnson may elect to take girlfriend Carrie Symons with him, too. Guests come and go throughout the summer, and their wing of the 1,000-room castle is carefully picked to ensure everyone has a comfortable stay. But this year, as the Cambridges' and Sussex's timings clash, Prince William and Kate are not staying in the castle at all. Instead, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge have been invited to stay in their own cottage, Tamanagar, in the grounds of the estate, with their three children. While the Duke and Duchess of Sussex are expected to be set up in the main house with their baby, Archie. The revelation has led to speculation about the state of the relationship between brothers William and Harry. A source close to the palace said, "The Queen has a lot of guests coming, and to ease the pressure, the Cambridges are likely to stay at the cottage. That could have added benefits for everyone as it means more space in the castle. Other guests include Prince Edward and the Countess of Wessex and their two children, and Princess Anne. Prince Charles and Camilla stay at Burke Hall, the late Queen Mother's house in the grounds of the estate, but they are also regularly at Balmoral. The source said, it can get quite busy at what they call the big house and it's not especially relaxing even though it's a holiday. There's a daily routine which evolves around meal times, several outfit changes every day, sometimes five, and the Queen likes everything to run like clockwork. The focus is on being outdoors and in the countryside walking, grousing, fishing and hunting. While it's a time of year when the Queen is mostly off duty and can put her feet up, guests are still expected to pull their weight. They are expected to join the Queen and Prince Philip for meals, including picnic and barbecues, no matter the weather. Guests are also expected to help with the clearing and washing up so that the Queen's staff get to have a break between service.